भ्यो नमः हरिः ॐ श्रुतिस्मृतिआलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादशंकरं ॐ जन्माद्यस्य यतः ब्रह्मजिज्ञासितव्यमित्युक्तम् किं लक्षणकम् पुनस्तद्ब्रह्म इत्यत आह भगवान् सूत्रकारः जन्माद्यस्य यतः इति. दिस इज कॉल्ड संबंध भाष्यम. सो दिस डिस्क्राइब्स द संगति द कनेक्टिविटी बिटवीन द एर्लियर अधिकरण एंड दिस अधिकरण. In the earlier adhikarana, it was said that you have to do jijnyasa of the Brahma. Brahma jijnyasitavyam means Brahma vicharaha kartavyaha. You have to do Brahma vichara. Always people should do karana vichara. They should not do karya vichara. Karya vichara is discussion or inquiry about the jagat. The karya, jagat is karyam. So inquire about the jagat. So what is there, what is here. So suppose you inquire about the geography, then you have to go by tourism and see those places and come back. That is how that inquiry leads to going wrong. How is there? That how vichara if you do about the jagat, then you have to go there and enjoy a few things there and come back. So always jagat vichara binds us inside the jagat. So karya vichara should not be done. You should do karana vichara. What is the cause of this jagat? That kind of vichara you have to do. So in fact karya vicharaha bandhanam, karana vicharo mokshaha. Like that there is a rule. So whenever you do karana vichara, the inquiry into the karana, that leads to freedom. Like suppose you do vichara of the ornaments, then you will be bound. So you have to go somewhere, purchase them, and having purchased, you have to wear them. Having worn, you have to show to others, and having shown to others, you have to protect them. Because when you show to others, some of them will try to steal them. So you have to protect them. So this is the, that is how karya vichara binds. Some of the examples which I know, if I tell you, you will feel stunned. You see, the karya vichara, the golden ornaments thing is like that. On the other hand, if you do the vichara of the gold, that the gold is the karana. If you understand gold, what is gold? It's a noble metal. And what is a metal? The nature of metal. Metal is like any other material, but metal has a particular chemical bond called metallic bond, because of which the bond between different atoms, because of which it allows the flow of electricity, it is amenable to magnetization. Like that there are some metallic properties. That is the metal. Then what is the specialty of gold among metals? It's a noble metal. Why noble? That vichara, it doesn't bind you. In fact, if you do this vichara a little seriously, you won't feel like wearing any golden ornament. For example, I don't feel any gold ornament because I have studied about gold. I'm not interested in the wearing the gold. I know whatever little I know about gold, that is enough. So the chemistry people who study gold or the physics people who study gold, they don't wear any ornaments. You look at them. Because that freedom they get out of that study. So karana vichara is like that. Always makes the person free. Karya vichara binds. Therefore you have to do Brahma vichara, Brahma jagat karanam, Brahma vijijnyasitavyam, Brahma jijnyasitavyam ityuktam. Okay. But to do vichara, you have to know what is its lakshanam. Kim lakshanakam tad Brahma? That is the question. Okay. Lakshana pramana abhyam vastu siddhihi iti nyayaha. So a vastu, a thing, you know it. Siddhi means it becomes established. Means you know it well. With the help of two. One is lakshana and the other is pramana. Lakshana means kaisa hai. How does it look like? So that is lakshana. And how to know it? That is pramana. Therefore lakshana pramana together establish a thing. Like prithivi. Prithivyah lakshanam kim? Gandhavatvam prithivyah lakshanam. Gandhavati prithivi. And so kaunsa pramana hai? Nak. Nose is the pramana for gandha, you know. Pratyaksham pramanam. So therefore that is how prithivi gandhavatva rupa lakshana pratyaksha pramana together they established prithivi. This is how lakshana pramana abhyam vastu siddhihi. So once you know the lakshana, pramana also gets established automatically. Pramana follows from lakshana. Depending upon the lakshana, pramana will be established. Therefore you have to follow. So you should first know lakshanam. Kim lakshanam? Kim lakshana kam punastad brahma punaha means if so, if we have to do the vichara of the brahma, then tad brahma kim lakshana kam. Kim lakshana kam is bahuvrihi samasa. Kim lakshanam, lakshana pullinga napumsakalinga, pullinga, lakshanam napumsakalingam. Kim lakshanam yasya tat, kim lakshanam ho sakta hai. Or because ka is there, swatheka prachayaha. Kim lakshanam yasya tat, kim lakshanakam. That is the bahurihi, that brahma, what kind of lakshana it has. So ityata aha, Bhagavan sutrakara, he doesn't say Bhagavan Vedavyasaha. It is not Vedavyasa. So now you can go and tell outside, as Swami TV says, he dismisses Vedavyasa, you can tell people. There will be people anywhere, Swami TV dismisses Vedavyasa. I am not dismissing Vedavyasa. For everything it is not Vedavyasa. Sutrakaraha Badarayanaha, he is different. No, Badarayana is Vedavyasa, not. Badarayana is a gentleman, Vedavyasa is a title. So they are two different things. Like Gopalakrishna is the same as a collector, revenue collector. Revenue collector is a title. Gopalakrishna is a name. Dono ek nahi hai. Therefore, so people, some entrenched notions will be there. Nobody should question those notions. How can that be? If nobody should question, then that is not called vichara. In vichara, everything will be put to examination. Everything will be questioned. You see, vichara, there is a rule for vichara. Prayojanavati vicharo nabhavati. Vasana anusarini vicharo nabhavati. Suppose you want to know about gold, vichara. Now, what will I get out of that vichara? No, you don't do any vichara now. Suppose you don't get any benefit by knowing about gold. Therefore, you will not do vichara or what? Prayojananusari nabhavati vicharaha. You don't get any benefit out of that vichara. That is a vyaparam. It is business, you know. Vichara is not a business. Here you don't look for what benefit I will get out of vichara. You do not look for that. That is number one. Benefit or no benefit? Vichara you do. But for the sake of vastu siddhi. And then vasananusarini nabhavati. Vasananusari nabhavati vicharaha. Vasana is some your fixations, your notions and your ideas which are sitting there in the mind. The vichara cannot be conducted according to those vasanas. You should know all these things. So, karma prayojananusari bhavati. Prayojananusari bhavati. Natu vicharaha. Natu jnanam. Jnanam prayojanan, it doesn't follow prayojana, phala and all that. Karma that is. So, vasana, upasana, vasananusari bhavati. So, what kind of upasana you do? It depends upon your vasana. The person is a sattvika, his nature of upasana will be sattvika. And the person has tamasa vasanas, his upasana also will be tamasa. That is, but jnanam has nothing to do with your vasanas. Therefore, the vichara has to be done with a very open and pliable mind. So, what is the lakshanam of the Brahma? For that, Sutrakara replies, Janmadhyasya yata iti. This is how this sutra is connected to the earlier sutra. Then yataha means yasmat, that yachyadena, purva sutrokta brahma paramrishyate. So yataha means yasmat brahmanaha, from which brahma. Like that brahma shabda comes down here. Okay? Asya idam shabda. Idam shabda means pratyaksha anumana sannidhapitam jagat. Because jagat is mostly why? Entirely pratyaksha anumana pramana siddham jagat. Therefore, that jagat is idam shabda, idam shabdasya arthaha. Therefore, asya jagataha. So, janmadi yataha. The discussion will continue. Let us see what Bhashyakara says. Vishayavakya is yatova imani bhutani jayante. That is the Vishayavakya. Okay. Janma utpattihi adirasyam iti tadguna samvijnano bahuvrihihi. This we have seen. So janma adi iti bahuvrihi, which refers to anyapadartha. What is the anyapadartha? It is a samudaya, one group. One group is the anyapadartha. What is that group? That aggregate. Janmasthiti bhangam samasartha. So the group of three things, janmasthiti and bhanga. Bhanga is laya, janmasthiti laya. The three, the etrayad, that janmasthiti bhangam. So make it into a unit. That is called samaharadvandva, a triad of janma and sthiti and bhanga. That is the meaning of janmadi, because of the tadguna samvijnana bahuvrihi. In tadguna samvijnana, we carry that janma forward. We do not drop it altogether. So, we carry, like chitra guhu, the chitraha gavaha are entirely left out. Whereas here, the janma, and that being the first, that all that both words and their meaning come into the anyapadartha. That's why it is tadguna samvijnano bahuvrihihi. Then between janma, sthiti and laya, how can you say janma is first? You see, it's a cycle, you know. It's not a straight line, a cycle. In cycle, you cannot say which is first and which is last. That is the idea of the discussion. So born, then existed for a while, sthiti, it sustains, and then it dies or gets resolved, then again born. Like that, the three are there, a group of three. In this group of three, janmasthiti bhanga, why do you call it janmasthiti bhangam? Why not call it sthiti bhanga janma? Because their sutrakara seems to call it janmasthiti bhangam. He begins with janma. Why to begin with janma? I would like to call it bhanga janmasthiti. I may want to begin it with bhanga or begin it with sthiti. Why janma? There must be some reason for it. So then the sutra could be sthityadhyasya yataha. Why not? Bhangadhyasya yataha. Why not? Why only janmadhyasya yataha? He is saying that, you know. So vichara will be like that. Okay. Why, what will we do with all this vichara? Nah, come on. That prayojanam sari vicharo nabhavati. Okay. So don't look for prayojanam. This is not kamya karma. Okay. So you engage your mind in the analysis and in the contemplation on the higher things. That is the karana vicharaha. Janmanascha aditvam shruti nirdesha peksham vastu vrutta peksham cha. That is the sangraha bhashya. So janma is taken as adi based on two reasons. One is the shruti nirdesha apeksham. So considering, apeksha is considering here, considering the shruti vakya, because వేదాంత సూత్ర ది సూత్రాస్ ఆర్ అబౌట్ ది శృతి వాక్యాస్ దట్ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు సే లెటర్ సో దెర్ ఈస్ ఆల్వేస్ ఎ విషయ వాక్య ఇన్ ది విషయ వాక్య ద సీక్వెన్స్ ఆఫ్ జన్మస్థితి భంగ ఈస్ ఫాలోడ్ అండ్ వాట్ ఎవర్ సీక్వెన్స్ వాస్ ప్రెసెంటెడ్ దేర్ నిర్దేశ దట్ వీ ఫాలో హియర్ బికాస్ సూత్రాస్ ఆర్ అనలైజింగ్ ఓన్లీ శృతి వాక్యాస్ దట్ ఈస్ వన్ రీజన్ దట్ ఈస్ గుడ్ ఇనఫ్ రీజన్ యూ డోంట్ నీడ్ టు బాదర్ అబౌట్ ఇట్ ఎనీ ఫర్దర్ శృతి ఫాలోస్ దట్ సీక్వెన్స్ సూత్ర ఫాలోస్ దట్ సీక్వెన్స్ లైక్ ఎ స్టెనోగ్రాఫర్ హీ పుట్స్ పారాగ్రాఫ్స్ ఇన్ వన్ ఆర్డర్ వై డూ యూ పుట్ దిస్ ఆర్డర్ బికాస్ ది బాస్ హూ డిక్టేటెడ్ పుట్ ఇన్ దట్ ఆర్డర్ ఆల్సో ఐ పుట్ ఇన్ దట్ ఈస్ హౌ ఇట్ ఈస్ దట్ ఈస్ వన్ రీజన్ గుడ్ ఇనఫ్ రీజన్ అనదర్ రీజన్ ఈజ్ వృత్త నిర్దేశాపేక్షంచ వృత్త ఈజ్ వస్తు వృత్తాపేక్షంచాయా వస్తు వృత్త ఈజ్ కండక్ట్ వర్తతే సో వస్తు ది ఎనీథింగ్ యూ సీ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ యూ లుక్ అట్ ఎనీథింగ్ ఇన్ దిస్ వరల్డ్ ఎనీథింగ్ వస్తు ఎనీథింగ్ అండ్ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ ఆల్ ది త్రీ జన్మ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ స్థితి ఇట్ హ్యాస్ భంగ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ Now, where it begins, you take any vastu, ghata, you take it, it has janma, sthiti, bhanga. Now, how it begins? Ghata, how it begins? With bhanga begins or sthiti begins? With janma it begins, okay? Therefore, look around, it all begins with janma, everything begins with janma. Like clay is the cause and ghata is the effect. And the ghata begins with the janma. And then sthiti and bhanga. It begins with sthiti and then bhanga and then janma. Aisa nahi hai. Therefore, the behavior, vartta is behavior of the objects of the world. If you take that into consideration also, the triad always begins with janma. Okay? Now he is explaining all that. This is Sangraha Bhashyam. ఈజ్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయినింగ్ శృతి నిర్దేశస్తావత్ తావత్ మనే ప్రథమం దేర్ ఆర్ టూ రీజన్స్ హీ సెడ్ ఫర్ ది ట్రయాడ్ టు బి ఇన్ దట్ సీక్వెన్స్ సో ది ఫస్ట్ రీజన్ ఈజ్ శృతి నిర్దేశ ది ప్రెజెంటేషన్ బై ది శృతి ఆఫ్ ది త్రీ ఇన్ దట్ పర్టికులర్ ఆర్డర్ హౌ యతో వా ఇమాని భూతాని జాయంతే ఇత్యస్మిన్ వాక్యే జన్మస్థితి ప్రళయానాం క్రమదర్శనాత్ సో ఇత్యస్మిన్ వాక్య మీన్స్ నాట్ దట్ వాక్య అలోన్ అదర్ వాక్యాస్ ఆల్సో యూ హావ్ టు టేక్ ఏ నజాతాని జీవంతి యత్ ప్రయంత్యభిసంవిశంతి ప్రయంతి ఇణి గతౌ ధాతు ప్రా ఉపసర్గ యంతి ఏతి ఇతః యంతి దట్ ప్రయంతి యంతి మీన్స్ గోయింగ్ ప్రయంతి మీన్స్ వన్స్ ఫర్ ఆల్ గోయింగ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ సంథింగ్ లైక్ హీఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు హరిద్వార్ మీన్స్ హీ విల్ కమ్ బ్యాక్ రైట్ యంతి యాతి బట్ సపోజ్ హీఈస్ గోయింగ్ ఓన్లీ గోయింగ్ ఓన్లీ నో కమింగ్ బ్యాక్ దెన్ వీ సే ప్రయాతి సిమిలర్లీ ప్రయాణం ప్రయాణకాలే చ దట్ ప్రయాణ గీత సో ప్రయాణ ఈజ్ డెత్ యాన ఈజ్ గోయింగ్ ప్రయాణ సో హియర్ ప్రయంతి ది హోల్ వరల్డ్ గోస్ అండ్ మెర్జెస్ అండ్ హ్యావింగ్ మెర్జ్డ్ అభిసంవిశంతి వాట్ ఈస్ దట్ ప్రయంతి ఇట్ ఈస్ ఫర్దర్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్డ్ యాజ్ అభిసంవిశంతి ఆర్ కార్యరూపేణ ప్రవిశ్య సంపూర్ణతయా విలయంయాతి లైక్ దట్ యూ కెన్ మేక్ ఎ స్మాల్ డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ ప్రయంతి ఫస్ట్ ఇట్ ఎంటర్స్ ఇన్ టు ఇట్ రిటైనింగ్ ఇట్స్ కార్యరూప దెన్ ఇట్ లూజెస్ ది కార్యరూప ఆల్సో అభిసంవిశంతి లైక్ దట్ యూ కెన్ మేక్ ఎ స్మాల్ డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ ది టూ ఆర్ సింప్లీ యూ కెన్ సే ప్రయంతి ఈజ్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్డ్ యాజ్ అభిసంవిశంతి ప్రయంతి ఇత్యస్యైవ వ్యాఖ్యానం అభిసంవిశంతి ఇది దట్ వే దెన్ దెర్ ఈజ్ అనదర్ ఇష్యూ దేర్ ప్రీయ తర్పణే లైక్ దట్ దెర్ ఈజ్ అ ధాతు ప్రీ తర్పణే ఓకే ప్రీయ తర్పణే యు మేక్ ఇట్ లట్ ఫర్ దట్ ప్రీ అండ్ అంతి అంతి విల్ కమ్ జీ బికమ్ బహువచనం ఇట్ బికమ్స్ జీ అంతి దెన్ షప్ యు మేక్ ప్రీ ఆ అంతి దెన్ అతో గుణే హోతా హైనా and then guna you have to make, guna you have to make, then finally you have to do ato guna, ato guna. So first you do guna and then ayadesha, it becomes prayanti. Prayanti mane trupyanti ichartha. So it becomes like that, prenanti ichartha. So the jagat, as it resolves in Paramatma, it acquires a status of fulfillment. That kind of a meaning also you can give. But that kind of explanations itself, just look at the Rupa Chandrika and find prayanti in two different dhatus. In Inagitav, in Inagatav you will get prayanti with pra upasarga, and without upasarga, pri tarpade dhatu you get prayanti. So that kind of playing with it, some people do it. If you have utsaham, you can do it. But not necessary, I suppose. Inagatav is enough. And then abhisamvishanti becomes the vyakshanam of the prayanti. You have to deal with it like that. Therefore, three things only. Janmasthiti bhanga. So if you put trupti also in between, then it becomes four. Out of the four, trupti and abhisamvesha, though you have to merge and call it bhanga, whatever. So therefore, three vakyas, those three vakyas together constitute the Vishaya vakya for this. Didala eka vakya, eka vakya. So, ityasmin vakya, eka vakyata. Vakya is not sentence as such, the topic. The entire topic is called vakya, that is eka vakya. Now, in this vakya, you see the sequence. It begins with janma. Therefore, the sutrakara follows the janma. Vastuvrtamapi. So even vastuvrtta, the conduct of the behavior of any object in this world, follows the same sequence. How? Janmana labdha satta kasya dharminaham. Sthiti pralaya sambhavat. You see, janma, sthiti, bhanga, they are the dharmas. Dharmas means properties, okay? And what is the thing that has the properties, these three properties? Anything that is called dharmi. Like ghata is a dharmi. It need not be ghata, it could be anything. Pata it could be, kudya it could be. That is the dharmi. And then these three are the dharmas. So first, the dharmi should come into existence. Labdha satta kasya. It should come into existence. How does it come into existence? By janma. Janmana labdha satta kasya. First it acquires the existence. So vidyate that way. And then it becomes sthiti. The sthiti begins and continues. And then it breaks up. That is bhanga. So that is how the conduct of the objects also you can see. Therefore, you follow the same sequence. Why to change that sequence? That is how janmadi. That is how it is janmadi. That settles. So janmadi word. Then he comes to asya. Asyeti prachakshadi sannidhapitasyam dharminaha idama nirdeshaha. Idama means by idam shabda. Okay? Idam shabdaha. Idam shabdaha. You see, the swarupam of the shabda. Idam shabda swarupa. Suppose in the meaning, if you take artha, suppose the meaning of the word idam you take, then prathama vivakti, tritiya vivakti will be anena, pullinga, okay? But instead of taking the meaning, you take the swarupa, ikara, dakara, kara, makara, halanta, that swarupa if you take, then prathama ekavachanam, suppu will come upon the swarupa itself. Therefore, prathama ekavachanam will be idam. Idam su. Halinyabhyo dirghat sutisya praktam halu iti sublopaha. So idam. Tritiya ekavachanam will be idam ta idama. That is the idama. Okay? In Mundakopanishad Bhashya, there is one place, tada. Tada. at that place, if the person says tada, then he doesn't know the bhashya correctly. That is the meaning of it. Tada means tachabde lai chatta. Aisa hota hai. Kabhi kabhi. So aisa bhi hota hai. Anyway, so idama. Idama nirdeshah. By the word idam. By the word idam. By the word idam, dharminaha. Which is presented before you by prachakshadi pramanas. That is how idam shabda is used. Whatever dharma, suppose you say I am ghataha, there idam shabda you have used. What is the basis for the use of the idam shabda? That vastu called ghataha is presented before you by prachaksha pramana. Then you say I am parvataha vanhiman. There you say again the anumana pramana sannidhapita vanni matvam. Anumana pramana sannidhapita vanni matvam ayam shuddena idam shuddena nirdishyate. Like that you have to take. So prachaksha anumana, you see, when I say prachaksha anumana, you should not ask me later, hey Swami, he forgot arthapati. I include all those things in anumana, okay? Upamana, arthapati, artha anupalabdhi, etc., etc. If you have some more, all of those things also, I include in anumana, okay? So don't think that I have left out something. Every time, pramana, you get excited and start giving the whole list. Not necessary like that, okay? Be quiet. Okay. Idama nirdeshaha. Dharminaha idama nirdeshaha. The dharmi gets nirdesha. Dharminaha nirdeshaha. The pointing out of the dharmi. Whatever dharmi it is, like ayam ghataha, ghataha is the dharmi. What is the dharma? Prachaksha pramana sannidhapitatvam. That is the dharma, that is the dharmi. That is how idam shabda is used. Shashti janmadi dharma sambandhartha. Shashti sambandhartha. Wherever you get shashti, It means sambandha, some kind of a contact with, connection between the two, not contact, connection. Because the other six vibhaktis are the karaka vibhaktis. They determine the type of involvement in the kriya for the thing. Karaka means kriyanvayi karakam. Kriyam anveti iti karakam. So, karta, karma, etc. This shashti vibhakti, that doesn't participate in the kriya. It is not karaka. Therefore, what is its meaning now? Sambandha is the meaning. Sesha. Wherever sesha comes, you have to be extremely careful in Panini's situation. You have to be very careful. Sesho ghya sakhi. I don't even remember what is the seshaha there, I tell you. I said it. Seshaha is very dangerous thing it is. Seshat kartari parasmai padam. Sesha is very dangerous. Amo. There are so many other seshas. So Panini sashti sheshe. He put a huge mountain of burden upon your head. Now you have to struggle with that sutra. What is this sesha? Tekakaras, they help us, of course. Sesha, what is this sesha? Now you look at the literature and you take out all the six karakas, and now what else is left? That is how you have to struggle with the sesha. They have come to the conclusion that everything is taken care of except a few things which all can be clubbed under the meaning of sambandha. Therefore, sheshe shashti mane sambandharthe shashti, like that they take. What is the sambandha? There are so many sambandhas. You see, even in our life, how many relations you have? Sambandha means what? The bandhu. Kitne bandhu hai? So many of them. Brother-in-law, brother, cousin-brother, brother's sister, sisters, brother, and like that, so many are there. Similarly, here also they counted and arrived at 101 sambandhas. So ekashatam shashtyarthaha, like that they have settled. Shankara, he said sambandha, connection. So asya janmadi. So with this, whatever that this is, with this janma sthiti bhanga are connected. Therefore, it means whose janma? The janma of this, the sthiti of this, the bhanga of this. In English, of. In Sanskrit, shashti, sambandharthe. Okay, that way you have to understand it. Then he did not say the meaning of the asya yet. Asya, now he is saying yata iti karana nirdeshaha. So yataha always talks of the karana. Yataha yasmat. Yasmat panchami. Panchami hetu. Therefore, yasmat karanat ichartha. Yasmat mane, yasmat karanat ichartha. So, then what is the karanam? There are so many karanas. So, you see, generally, nayayikas and vaisheshikas, for them, when they say karanam, it is nimitta karanam. That is how they take it. Okay? Like, ayanghataha, yasmat karanat utpannam, they are talking about the kulala, the pot maker. They are not talking about clay. In fact, they say, we need not talk about clay. Clay is sitting there only. Upadana karanam prachakshataha vartate karanam karye anveti. That is the upadana karana. Upadana karana is already entering into the karya and it is there in the karya. Therefore, prachaksha it is there. When karanam is, whatever karanam is prachaksham, that why to do vichara about that? You need not do vichara. Whereas nimitta karana is not prachaksham. Right? So this cup, karanam kim? Karanam kim? What is the answer? So this company which is there in Delhi or Jalandhar, that is the karanam. That is how we are looking for nimitta karanam only. We are not looking for steel karanam. Steel, we can see steel. You need not tell that it is made of steel. This is how Nayayikas look at it. They are not dumb guys. They have their own reason. So for that reason, they say yasmat karanat mane yasmat nimitta karanat. And therefore, the jagataha nimitta karanam ishvaraha. That is how they take. So, then what is the upadana karanam? Upadana karanam, you look at it and you will find. So, paramanu sati upadana karanam. They are scientists, I tell you. We should appreciate them. That is how they look. And for them, for Vedantins, so they want upadana karanam. They have their own reasons for it. I will come to that. So here, we are looking at upadana karanam only. We are not looking at the nimitta karanam. And we say upadana karanam, and then we will merge nimitta karanam in that. Because we are talking of Brahma, athato Brahma jignyasa, and yataha brahmanaha. You have to say yataha brahmanaha. Yataha means yachyatena, brahma shabdaha paramrishyate, yataha brahmanaha. Asya jagataha janmadi bhavati. That is how they have to say. And therefore, that a Brahma is the karanam. Now what kind of karanam? Suppose you say Brahma nimitta karanam. Like Tarkikas say, you say Brahma nimitta karanam. Then it is not Brahma anymore. Because Brahma means sarva vyapakam. It must be all. It is a part cannot be Brahma, you know. It is whole. And this thing is outside the whole. Now then this cannot be the whole. So, Brahma nimitta karanam, upadana karanam is separate. If you say like that, then that is not Brahma. So, this is what is called mulochedaha. You wanted to define Brahma and you end up defining that which is not Brahma. Therefore, you cannot say nimitta karanam. Then let us say upadana karanam. Then also it is not Brahma. Because upadana karanam is Brahma, but nimitta karanam is anyat. Then that also that is not Brahma. Then to make Brahma as Brahma, to keep its sanctity, you have to say that it is both nimitta and upadana. It is abhinna nimitta upadanam karanam. You have to say like that. Otherwise, that yataha doesn't sit there properly. Then questions come. How can nimitta can be upadana and upadana can be nimitta? It cannot be, you know. So that kind of questions will come. We have to answer all those questions. Yeah. But first, asya jagataha. Asya means jagataha. Prachaksha sannidhapitasya jagataha. What is jagat then? First you should understand what is jagat. Namarupabhyam vyakrutasyam. Namarupabhyam iti itham bhava lak, itham bhota lakshane tritiya. It is also called itham bhava. Means namarupa rupena vyakrutasya ityartha. That is the itham bhava. So as namarupa, that is the tritiya vibhakti. As, yes, as. Not by namarupa. Suppose you say by namarupa. But karana, it is not karana. As namarupa. Okay? Jatabhistapasaha, that is jatal jatarupyaha tapasaha. Jatabhistapasaha, that is this Bhattuji Dikshita. Okay? So, namarupa bhyam vyakrutasya, that is the jagat. Jagat is what is expressed, that is jagat, vyakruta. First you should understand vyakaranam. Vyakruta is vyakaranam, you know. Vyakaranam, that is vyakaranam. Karanam is doing. Karanam is doing. Now we doing vividha, vividha karanam. Doing a variety of things, that is vyakaranam. And akaranam, asamantat. Doing a variety of things, and in every kind, covering everything. Like, you go to, you are walking by the side of a potmaker's house. In the morning, he has a heap of clay put before his home. And then you go somewhere and come back in the evening, then there are two lines of small pots. Another two lines of middle-sized pots. Two lines of big parts, and then another two lines of lids, two lines of cups. Like that, you have the kruti there, the karanam. So many things he did. Karanam. What kind of karanam? Vikaranam, akaranam. Vikaranam, small parts, bigger parts, big parts, cups, that is vikaranam. Akaranam, the whole line is small parts, the whole line is cups. That is akaranam. Put V and A. Vya. In English, this I say, I point out to the students, because we are teaching in English, you know. No, no, we don't care for English. Then why are you teaching in English? Hindi mein padha padha. Don't teach in English. If you teach in English, do it properly in English, right? So, this V karanam, it is called variegated in English. Akaranam is called multitudinous. And combining the two, you have a word called multifarious. Therefore, multifarious is equal to variegated and multitudinous. That is vyakaranam. And here, it is an expression. Expression. So, clay is expressed in a variety and multitude of name forms, namarupa. That is vyakaranam. Here, Ratna Prabhakara, I would like to say. You see, he says, yatha kumbhakaraha. You see, kumbhakaraha vyakaranam karoti. How he is doing vyakaranam? Yatha kumbhakaraha prathamam kumbha shabda bhedena vikalpitam. First he thinks kumbha, he says. That's why he is called kumbhakaraha. He tells in his mind kumbham, kumbhaha or kumbhaha, like that. Then even while saying the word kumbha, in his mind the form is formed, because shabda and rupa, nama and rupa, shabda and nama, one and the same, they go together. So vikalpitam, so rupa is already visualized in his mind. What is the rupa? Pruthu buddhuno darakara swarupam. So the rupa is a narrow mouth and expanded belly. That's why human beings also, when they grow the belly, that belly is called pot belly, because the pot has a narrow mouth and a wide belly, you know, just like a human being. That's why the pot example is applied here. So that shape with a narrow mouth and a huge belly shape, he imagines. So buddhav alikhya, he draws that shape in his mind. Sometimes he may draw on the paper also. But what he draws on paper is written in the first in the buddhi, you know. So yan manasa manute tadeva vacha vadati tat karmana karoti. It is shrute. Hai shruti, hai shruti, hai. So we are mimamsaka for a while. Mimamsaka will be very happy. Yad vacha vadati tadeva karmana karoti iti shrute, he'll be happy. Amma boy, this guy has so much love for shruti. Aisa. So, means they are followers. They don't want to think. They follow. That is the character. In following, there is a security. In thinking, there is no security. You will not have security now. You have to figure out for yourself. You have to fend for yourself. Whereas in following, there is a security. You see, you look at a bright MSc student. A bright MSc student. He is very secure, very assured person. Because he is studying the books and he is following the lectures. Studying the books means whatever is written in the books, printed in the books, he is following it. And tomorrow in the exam, he will write what all he followed and he will get good marks. And he gets university first. Then he joins research. In research you don't follow. Following is over. Now he starts thinking. And thinking is not happening. It thinks a little and it bounces back. Thinks a little and bounces back. Thinks a little, bounces back. And then he gets stunned. And the boss says, come on, think like that. Boss doesn't oblige. And so thinking you have to do. Boss cannot do on your behalf, you know. You have your hands upon the thing, and so you have to think and work out. Therefore boss will be running away this way, that way. You cannot catch hold of him. Therefore you have to think. So the research scholars are very frustrated people. Very frustrated. Because there is no security. And he is given a scholarship for 3 years. And the years are going on, the months are going on, and the results are not coming, thinking is not progressing. And after the scholarship will come or not, he doesn't know. Very insecure, I tell you, in thinking. Why I am saying all this? Did you get the spirit of what I am saying? So people are followers. They do not think. Because in following, there is a security. In thinking, there is no security. You are on your own. In following, you have an entire parampara to support you. And therefore, this parampara is the following thing it is. And therefore, there is no originality anymore. And it helps you to stop thinking and remain secure in no thinking. And therefore, you lose your originality, creativity, all that you lose. And the whole life is gone in following. And life gets wasted. Because you don't get anything out of following. Nitya. That's why I told all this story. Anyway, Buddha Valikya. So first, he draws the figure in his mind. Tadatmana kumbham vyakaroti. Kumbham vyakaroti. You see, he is doing vyakaranam of the kumbha. You know what meaning he gives? Bahir prakatayati. That's why he said, you don't create a part. You don't create a part. You express a part. What is created? Nothing is created. Suppose you assume, I will give you an example. This is what? A paper. Okay? This is what? A cone. Now, did I create a cone out of paper? Or I expressed the paper as cone? I expressed the paper as cone. There is no creation the way people believe it. There is no such creation. So, ajata is the truth. There nothing is created. Like I take a lump of clay and play with it. Use some instruments also for playing with it very efficiently. And then bring out a form out of the same clay. A form, a rupa. And that rupa goes with a nama and call it ghata. So you have not created anything. You have expressed a rupa. But don't say rupa and keep quiet. Because rupa comes with a nama. Without nama there cannot be any rupa. Therefore you have brought out, you have expressed a nama rupa. Bahir prakatayati. That is nama rupa vyakaranam. That's why even after the expression as part, it continues to be clay. It is not anything other than clay. Still it will have the smell of clay, it will have the weight of clay. What is the weight of the part? The weight of the clay. What is the molecular structure of the part? The molecular structure of the clay. So it continues to be the same clay, nothing different. In any which way you look at it, it is not different from the clay. Then what is it that you have created? You have created nothing. And that's why people who are hung upon janma, they miss the truth. There is no truth in janma. They miss the truth. Like I was born, you are missing the truth. You are going after some wild goose. Bahir prakatayati tatha paramakaranamapi svekshitam namarupatmana vyakaroti. That is how. Therefore, that paramakaranam, that is the jagatkaranam brahma, jagat vyakaroti. So jagat, it brings out of itself. It brings out of itself means it expresses out of itself. I prefer that. I prefer to say it expresses out of itself. Bahihi prakatayati. I was looking for the word for prakata. I was looking for the word. Do you have any better word? Don't say manifest. Because manifest doesn't mean expressing. Prakata. Manifest means parinama. Am I right? You think about it. Somehow I felt the moment you say manifest, it sounds as parinama. Parinama means there is a modification.
Not there to there.
This is modification. Manifest means there is a kind of a modification. So, therefore, Brahma now manifests. Can we say manifest? Brahma? That's why there are problems in saying manifest. That's why the moment you say manifest, so what happens is jagat appears real. And people who want jagat to be real, they use the word manifest. Gold manifests as ornaments, means ornaments as real. This is what I am saying. I may be wrong, you please correct me. You just check those words and you correct me. I prefer at this stage to say express. Later, I have a better word than that, in which there is nothing to correct. It is only a matter of understanding. I will use the word appears. That is clean. But at this point of time, I am not yet saying appears, you know. That appears, I will come. I will come to that. But before I come to that, I have to use an expression, a word for explaining this vyakaranam. So vyakarana I have to explain. And I am taking the example of a pot. And therefore, so keeping the pot in mind, I have to use a word that applies to the pot situation as well as the jagat situation at this point of time. Therefore, I follow Ratna Prabha. And Ratna Prabhakara uses the word prakatayati. Prakatayati, I thought about it, and for me, express is the best possible word. Okay? So Brahma expresses itself as the Jagat. If you want to put manifest, you are welcome. It is not about the semantics of the word. Manifest. Manifest meaning nothing new is created. The same thing is appearing as this. In that sense, we are using the word manifest. You are welcome. Because in the Shruti also, sometimes the word asurujata is used. And sometimes it is used akalpayat. So, tatteja aikshata, sat aikshata, tattejo asurujata, asurujata. And elsewhere, dhata yathapurvam, surya chandramasav akalpayat. That's why it is called kalpaha. Kalpanam, kalpaha is kalpanameva kalpaha. Kalpa, klup dhatu, kalpa, kalpaha with one prachaya, kalpanam in another prachaya. When you hear kalpanam, you know what it is. Mithya iti, spashtam. But when you hear kalpaha, you get excited. Oh, kalpaha, cycle, so many years, this, that. People are like that, fixated. Kalpanam eva, kalpaha. Kalpa vrukshaha mane kya hai? Oh, ek tree hota hai, vahan se fruit girte hai. Like that. Kalpa vrukshaha mane kalpanam eva. Kalpido vrukshai chattha. Some tree you are imagining it yattha. That is the kalpa vruksha. Anyway. कल्पवृक्षा कामधेनु वर्ड क्या कामधेनु क्या होता है कामधेनु एक अच्छा बहुत अच्छा गाय एक होता है और होती है वो गाय बहुत ज्यादा मिल्क देती है काफी पी सकते हैं दैट इज नॉट कामधेनु कामधेनु इज योर डिजायर्स आर कंसिडर्ड धेनु बिकॉज यू डिजायर समथिंग एंड टेक मेक मनी एंड गो टू द मार्केट एंड ब्रिंग समथिंग दैट्स व्हाई इट इज धेनु देयर इज नो धेनु. Now you tell Kamadhenu is there. It has a daughter, and the daughter has another name. So, like that. This is all Puranic stuff. Anyway. Namarupatmana. So, Namarupabhyam Vyakrutasya. This Namarupa, he is explaining. This Namarupa, you know, this Namarupa, it is merely an expression. Like clay itself is expressed. But once the expression is in place, it is so variegated and multitudinous that now you forget ekatvam and you get stuck anekatvam you take as real. You forget that rupa is only a buddhi parikalpitam rupam that you forget. And you are now attracted by the variety of rupas. And some rupas I like, some other rupas I don't like. You go into ragadvesha. Like that, the whole gamut of samsara is in place. Therefore, that vyakaranam is like that. That's why this is what is called maya. Because in maya, what happens? Aneka appears as aneka. People think becomes. Becomes. Manifest means what? Becomes. So, aneka becomes aneka. Really? Now, how aneka can become aneka really? If it can become aneka really, then how come it is eka in the first place? But anyway, so eka becomes aneka. And janmasthiti nasha rahitam becomes janmasthiti nasha sahitam. So that is jagat, you know. And advayam becomes sadvayam. So like that. And So how can it become? You have to say it doesn't become. But another way to say is mayaya bhavati ityapi vaktum shakyate. When you say mayaya bhavati, then it is you. Mayaya bhavati means what? So by maya it happens. Means it is not real ityartha. Now let us see this variety a little more. Aneka kartru bhoktru sanyuktasyam. This variety is associated with many kartas and many bhoktas. Okay, many jivas ityartha. Jiva is karta, bhokta, jivaha. Many jivas. So now God is playing not just one fool. He is playing many fools. And every fool is different from every other fool. Like Shakespeare's fools, they are different. King Lear's fool is different from A Midsummer Night's Dream's fool. Like that, fools also, fools different. Like that, so it is going on. You see in Bhagavatam, the other day I was talking about symbolism in Bhagavatam. At that time I did not remember, now I remember. Barhapidam natavara vapuhu. So, Bhagavan's vapuhu body is that of an actor. So, God playing the fool. You got it there, symbolism. Is the nata. Natyam is nata, natyam. So, Jagat is natyam. And Bhagavan is nata. Means, kya hai? It is all maya. And then, baraha, the word baraha comes from bruh. Bruh, bruhi, bruddhav. Bruh, a pratyaya. A is the krut pratyaya. Du guna. Baraha, then ajajya pashtap, baraha, then bruh, then samadhar prachaya, then brahma, like that. So, in baraha it is guna, in brahma it is radesha, refa desha. So, like that. So, bru gets bra, you know, refa adesha also comes in many number of times. Therefore, what is baraha there? Is Brahma. So Baraha is the expanded, the expansion. That is the Brahma. Deshakala Vastu Parichyada Rahitam. That is represented by the peacock. And Nata is the dance, Natya Nata. That is the Maya Shakti is represented. And flute is the Jiva without ego. So that is how you have to look at it. You should not take stories literally. Anyway, this I did not remember at that day, otherwise I would have told this also there. There are so many other things, but this also I would have told. I wrote an essay, this also I did not put in the essay because I forgot about it. So like that. Anyway. Pratiniyata desha kala nimitta kriya phalashtayasya. This namarupa vyakaranam, which is the jagat, it is the foundation, ashraya, for desha kala vastu. And then desha kala, okay? Nimitta is the vastu. Otherwise, desha kala and vastu. And the kriya, action is there. The action requires three things. Desha kala vastu. Because what is kriya? Kale, deshe kale cha vastunaha chalanam. Vastu has to move. For the thing to move, you need desha. And you need kala also. Without kala, how can there be movement? Without kala, there can be no movement. Therefore, desha kala. Then, because of the deshakala, you have kriya. That's why pratakale, gangatire, pujam karoti, like that, deshakala, they are there. And then kriyas, karmas will be there. And karmas will have phala. All these things. And for a particular kriya, for a particular phalam. Like you go to movie. In the movie it is all mithya, But still, villain will do all bad things and hero will do all good things. And heroine is, though it is mithya, she is very beautiful and she dances very well. Just because it is mithya, hero does all useless things and villain will do all good things and heroine sits in a corner. No, not like that. Though it is mithya, all systems are followed systematically. That is the pratiniyata. Just because things are very orderly, this order, just because there is order, therefore jagat is real. Kya baat kar rahe hai? Jagat is not real just because there is order. In spite of the order, it is unreal. In fact, I would say, because of the order, it is unreal. You show me order, that becomes unreal. Because the order is what? It is a product of the mind. You see, one Mahatma told me, it was a stunning revelation for me. He told me, you look at a garden, landscape garden, everything appears orderly. I said, oh, what an orderly garden. He said, look at that wild meadow. Yeah, I have looked at. Do you find any order? No, I don't find any order. Then he said, in the wild meadow, there is an order which is beyond the human thought. You tell me, in the wild meadow, is there an order or not, which is beyond human thought? The landscaped garden has an order created by human thought, whereas the wild meadow has an order which is beyond the human thought. Therefore, the order is not going to establish anything. There is some kind of order in the creation. Pratiniyata deshakala nimitta kriya phalashrayasya. So, here deshaha, kalaha. So, these two are fixed. Tathacha deshakala or nimitta for the kriya. For every kriya, deshakala or the nimitta. Certain deshe, certain kale, kriya. And the kriya will have phala, karma phala. All of them are contained within this namarupa vyakaranam that we call jagat. Okay? We'll come back. Om Purnamada Purnamidam. It's going a bit slow, it's all right.